A warm greetings from Dr. Muthuselvi, Professor in Computer Science Engineering Department in Comrade College of Engineering and Technology. Search algorithm, which is a very, very important topic in artificial intelligence. Of course, we know artificial intelligence is nothing but it is a search process. Let us see how the algorithm, it supports the artificial intelligence in searching. So now this algorithm, it takes a search problem as input and it returns a solution or an indication of search algorithm failure. And we have the search tree as well as the state space graph. So here the algorithm, it superimposes a search tree over the state space graph and forming various paths from the initial state and trying to find a path which is useful to find the goal. And here each and every node in the search tree, it corresponds to a state in the state space, and the edges node in the search tree, it corresponds to the actions. The root of the tree, actually it corresponds to the initial state of the problem. Of course, we start with the initial state of the problem, that is the root of the tree. Let us take one example. So here, starting from Arad, we are going to reach Bucharest. So we are going to have the tree for this one. So let us see three partial search trees for finding a route. Okay, so we are going to start from Arad city and we are going to reach the Bucharest. So when I expand Arad, either I can go to Sibiu, that is one city, or I can go to Timișoara, that is another city, or I can go to Zirin. So from Sibiu, I will reach so many cities like this, or from Timișoara, I can go to Arad or Lugoj. From Zirin, either I can go to Arad or Aradu. So this is one partial search tree when I am starting from Arad and I am trying to reach Bucharest. So you have Sibiu, Timișoara and Zirin. Starting from Arad, either I can go here, here or here. So from Sibiu, I can go to any one of the cities. So this is what the partial search tree. Now let us come to the algorithm. So here a new node is generated, which is called as a child node or successor node. For each of the child node, there is a successor node which results in the states. For example, I can take Arad as the parent node. From that, I can have Sibiu, Timișoara or Zirin. These are the child nodes. Now the question is, which of these three child nodes to be considered next? Either I can select Sibiu or Timișoara or Zirin. That is the question. Of course, I am going to have unexpanded nodes, which are called as frontier of the search tree. So for doing the search, we have one particular strategy called as uninformed search strategy. So here there is no clue given to the algorithm how close a state is to the goal. So that information is not given to the algorithm. One example, an uninformed agent in Arad with the goal of reaching Bucharest. So here from Arad I have to reach Bucharest, but no clue is given if I do not know the map of the Romania. Okay, so I don't know the path from Arad to Bucharest, so no clue is given to me. So that is known as uninformed agent. So here I don't have the knowledge of Romanian geography, and whether going to Zirin or Sibiu will be better, that also I do not know. So this particular strategy is called as uninformed search strategy. Another one, breadth first search. So here all actions have the same cost. So from one node to I am going to another node. So all the actions will have the same cost. So here I am going to expand the root node first, then the successes of the root node will be expanded next, then their successes, it will be going on. So it is simply a systematic search strategy. So it is also complete, we can say it is complete even on infinite state spaces. That is, though we may have innumerable state spaces, it is going to be complete. Let us take this example. I am going to have this simple binary tree. So we know in a binary tree, each and every every node has at most two children. So this is one example where we have the nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So I am starting from A, that is the root node. So I explore the children of A, that is B and C. So first I have to explore B, then I have to go to C, so the second child of node A. Then I will go to B node, the children of B, D and E, where D is the first children. So this is how I will do the breadth first search on a binary tree. The next one, it is depth first search. So here expands the deepest node in the frontier first. So it searches immediately to the deepest level of the search tree where the nodes have no successor. So we have to go to the deepest node which is not having any successor. So then we have the backup to the next deepest node, so that I will be able to explore all the unexpanded successor, but this one is not cost optimal. See, this is the example. Again, I am taking the binary tree with nodes like this. So A, B for B, D and E for D, H and I. So these are the nodes I have in the binary tree. So how I can do the depth first search? So I'll start from root node A, then I will explore B, that is the successor of A. Then again I will explore B, that is D and E. First I have to explore D, then again I will explore D, that is the H, that is the child of D node. So I will do like this, then I will go to I. So now I have to do the backtracking. After this is completed, I have to do the backtracking. I have to go to B, the other child is E. So now I have to explore E. So children of E, J and K, first I have to explore J. Then after that I will explore K, then I will do the backtracking. So from K to E, B to A, then the other child of C, another child of A is C, that is this one. So now I have to explore C. So F and G are there. First I have to explore F. So here L and M. So L is visited first, then I will go to M. Then again I have to do the backtracking. I have to come to C, then the other child is G, then I have to explore N and Q. So this is how I can do depth first search. Backtracking search, simply it is a variant of depth first search and it uses less memory. So that is the advantage we have here. So only one successor is generated at one particular time instead of exploring all the successors. So each partially expanded node remembers which successor to generate next. The successors generated by modifying the current state description, they are directly allocating the memory for a brand new state. And here the memory requirement, it is very much reduced. Another category, it is informed search, that is heuristic. So here a heuristic function h of n will be used. What is h of n? It is the estimated cost of the cheapest path from the state at node n to a goal state. So here it is useful in route finding problems. So here the estimation of the distance from the current state to the goal by computing the straight line distance on the map between the two points. Let us take the same example, reaching Bucharest from Arad. So here we have the values, distances. So from Bucharest to Arad 366, then from Bucharest to Craiova 160, like that the values are given. So now I am going to use these values to find out the heuristic function. So here greedy best first search, that is one important algorithm. So here it is form of a best first search. So the node with lowest h of n value, that is expanded first, that is the node that appears to be closest to the goal. So that is what the meaning of the node with lowest h of n value. So now the evaluation function f of n, it is simply equal to h of n, that is the heuristic function value. Let us take one example. So let us look at the different stages here. So initially I am here, that is Arad. So from Arad to Bucharest, the distance, that is 366. So after I expand Arad, either I can go here, go here, or go here. The values are given here. So from Arad to Cebu, it is 253. Timisoara, it is 329. Zirin, 374. Actually, all the units are in miles. Then after expanding Cebu, so from Cebu to Arad, from Cebu to Fagares, from Cebu to Ordeca, from Cebu to Rimanka. So these are the values given here, exact values. So after expanding Fagares, so from Fagares to Cebu 353, Fagares to Bucharest 0. So this is how one by one the nodes I will expand. Let us come to the next one, it is A star search. So here the evaluation function is modified like this, f of n is equal to g of n plus h of n. What is g of n? It is the path cost from the initial state to node n. H of n is the estimated cost of the shortest path from n to a goal state. So from what one particular node n to a goal state, what will be the shortest path I have to find, and for that path I would like to find the estimated cost. So now this f of n is estimated cost of the best path that continues from n to a goal. So here I would like to go for the shortest path. So that is the importance of A star search. See, initial state, again I am starting from Arad. After expanding Arad, I have Arad, Cebu, so 393, 140 plus 253. Then from Arad, Timisoara, so the value is equal to 447, that is 118 plus 329. Then from Zirin, the value I reach 449, which is equal to 75 plus 374. So from Cebu, I will reach these cities. So let us see what is the value. So from Cebu to Arad, it is 646. From Cebu to Fagares, it is 415. That is from adding 239 plus 176. Then Ardia, it is 671. So adding 291 and 380, then this city. So here 413, 220 plus 193. Similarly, I can expand this Rimini-Q Vilsia. So three more cities I have. So for this one it is 526. For the next one it is 417. For Cebu again it will be having the value 553. Now let us explore Fagaras. So here from Fagaras I will have this Cebu or Bucharest. So from Fagaras I will go to Cebu with the value 591. So this 338 plus 253, that is I will find the shortest path and I have estimated the cost as 253. Whereas for reaching this Bucharest from Fagaras I have the value 450. So again 450 plus 0. For this city Ardia I have this 671. So 291 plus 380. So from this particular node to reach Bucharest plus the shortest path I have to find and I will find the value, so that the final value is 671. So this is how I have to explore each and every node, that is I have to expand each and every city and I will find the value. And this is another example, that is after expanding Pitești city. So from here I can go to Bucharest, Craiova or this Rimini-Q Vilsia. So here for Bucharest the value is equal to 418, whereas for the next city it is 615. So the values are 455 plus 160. So the final value I have 615, and for this one it is 607. That is I am adding 414 plus 193. So these are the values actually I am going to have. So this is how I can do the A star search. Since here I include the shortest path and I find the estimated cost for the shortest path, A star search it is giving a good result when compared with the previous cases. Thank you.